Had you been vice president on January 6, 2021, what would you have done?
I stood up for the Constitution. I believe
it was an unconstitutional. What would you have done if you were vice president?
I would not have done what Mike Pence did. I don't think that was the right approach.
So that is Representative Elise Stefanik, who used to be a semi-reasonable Republican, but now she is trying out to be Donald Trump's VP. And so she's saying whatever she has to say, including that if she had been Mike Pence, she would not have fulfilled her role, her ceremonial role of certifying the results of the election. And she would have instead attempted to whatever extent she could, participate in the ongoing coup. If you don't recall all of the nonsense that was happening back then, we're just gonna quickly run through some of it, including that, of course, we had Donald Trump not just trying to pressure people like Mike Pence, but also Georgia Secretary of State Brad Raffensperger. Let's jump to this.
The ballots are corrupt, and you're going to find that they are, and which is totally illegal. It's more illegal for you than it is for them, because you know what they did, and you're not reporting it. That's a criminal offense. All I want to do is this. I just want to find 11,780 votes, which is one more than we have, because we won the state.
That is perhaps the most transparently corrupt and criminal phone call we've ever heard. If it's perfect, it's perfect only in those aspects. And it's important that we play that for you, because that's the man that Elise Stefanik is defending. That's the man who she says should have been able to overturn the results of the election. The guy who was calling up secretaries of state and not only telling them to just invent votes so that he wins, but implying, threatening them that they could be charged with breaking the law if they don't overturn the results of the election. But to return it to the Mike Pence stuff, of course, Donald Trump had this magical, mystical theory that Mike Pence could just decide, no, I know that you lost the election, but we're gonna give it to Donald Trump anyway. And it's now irrelevant. Mike Pence isn't in power, but Elise Stefanik is trying to signal to Donald Trump that if she is his running mate, then to whatever extent she can help him to evade the will of the people, legal consequences, she is ready to ride with him. Mondale, I want to go to you. What do you think of the representative?
People shouldn't think this is Marjorie Taylor Greene, right? This is the number three Republican in the House. The Republicans have a majority. This is dangerous speak. The idea that you should just curtail all of the laws in the Constitution that say how we transfer power peacefully until Donald Trump, to say that you would have not followed those rules should be disqualifying in itself. But in this moment in America, we know this just makes her more qualified to be the Republican vice president candidate. We should also mention that this is the same person who, you know, paraded out conspiracy theories about the great replacement of white American, right? The replacement theory. So I am not surprised. I am though scared. And also, like I said earlier in the show, the fact that we can no longer use America's democracy at threat because it's been burned so many times in the past, we are in serious trouble.
We might have millions of people watching this show, but you can be the difference maker, because we just need 1% of our audience to be paid members, and then this show can be around forever. So you can make that difference. Click join now.
Yeah, we are. We're in serious trouble. And this woman who used to live, I guess, a little bit in the world of reality is gone. And when she says she wouldn't have done what Mike Pence did on January 6th, does that include running, getting protection in fear of her life? What are those among the things that she would not have done? I didn't see her going and engaging with these peaceful people who are just trying to stand up for democracy. I think she probably is someone who is cowering and very scared. I wonder if her family recognizes her when she goes home anymore, because this is just pathetic. She should keep her mouth shut and not sit for these interviews anymore. She used to have a statement on her website that spoke about somewhat semblance of the truth from January 6th. And then, you know, when everybody ganged up on Liz Cheney, she decided to take it down and go with the flow.
Yeah, these are, despite in my free time being a bit of a writer, I don't have the vocabulary to truly describe what I think about people like Elise Stefanik. And Mondale, you made the reference to this is not Marjorie Greene, and that's true. They're two very different sorts of people, and the disdain that I feel for them is flavored by that. Marjorie Greene is an absolutely horrendous person, and she would be just as willingly a participant in a fascist takeover of America as Elise Stefanik. But honestly, like Marjorie Greene to me feels more like an Alex Jones. Marjorie Greene is a person who has never had the intellectual or psychological capacity to be anything other than a true believer. She reads something that she likes, it makes her tummy warm and it's insane, but she doesn't care. She likes how it feels and so that's what she believes. Elise Stefanik is almost worse because Elise Stefanik doesn't believe that any of these things she's saying are true. She has made a cold snake-like calculation in the wake of January 6th that she's not gonna be a Liz Cheney. She's not gonna be an Adam Kinzinger. She's not gonna be ejected from the party. She is going to say whatever she has to say to remain in power. She's hardly alone in that. Ted Cruz bowed down. You had Kevin McCarthy following January 6th after saying that Donald Trump was responsible for it. He then went and kissed the ring in Mar-a-Lago. Many of them have made the same decision. But honestly, it's again almost worse for her because she's specifically trying to become the VP, which doesn't just mean that she wants to be more of a leader in this attempt to dismantle whatever's left of American democracy, but she also knows that Donald Trump sent a mob to murder the last VP. And she's like, I want that job. I want to be that. I don't care. I might die. My family might be threatened. My family might be killed. But I really want to be VP. I want to have that ceremonial kind of non-power. And I'm willing to risk America. I'm willing to risk my own life. You referenced, Sharon, there what she was doing on January 6th. If the mob had found her on January 6th, they might well have brutalized her too. And she knows that as well. She knows all of these things. And still, she's lining up to be a part of this. It is utterly sickening. Any other thoughts, Sharon?
Can I just say, John? Because I'm guessing here, but I think I'm onto something when I say after that incident, she raced and called her husband, her children. Maybe she was talking with them throughout. She is worse than MTG, who sometimes doesn't know where she is and doesn't know the rules for anything. She's worse because she goes home. And she tells those kids, she has to. She can't tell them she's a liar. So she lies to them and tells them things like, I'm protecting America and the president is good. And she knows it's a vicious, dirty, stankin' lie. Mm-hmm. It's a stankin' dirty lie. She's worse.
Yeah, I mean, listen, I'm not out here defending MTG. So let's make sure our followers know that. But here's what I would say. You know, like this woman, you're right. She don't believe it because on January 6th, she was not for January 6th, right? She actually condemned. She called it a tragic and said she condemned their actions, all of that, right? It wasn't until, like you said, she made this calculated thought. And I think in calculation, she's thinking the VP is not a powerless role in this moment because Donald Trump, she's not sure how long he's going to be around. So I think that might be into her calculation as well, trying to, you know, seed her way into what it will be to be president. Here's the problem with it, though. Donald Trump has to win an election, and as popular as he is in the Republican Party, America is not the Republican Party.
Fingers crossed on that one, I'm just gonna say. I hope, but we'll see.
Hey, thanks for watching that video. We really appreciate it, guys. And we appreciate it if you become members because that allows us to be independent, honest, progressive, all the things that you don't get from corporate media. And all of that is because of you guys. Hit the join button below and become one of us, become a Young Turk.